The angel in the trench coat under the lamppost, my first new car, my first apartment, my first job, and the great big wig. Stories from my life. Grandma's porch. Sit down, relax, enjoy. Here on Grandma's porch. My first apartment, the big red car, and the angel under the lamppost in the trench coat. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brianne. Well, I've been telling stories from my life to kind of come up and be lighter, let up for air, so to speak, so that I am not talking only about heavy topics. And I kind of wanted to get away from the heavier topics. I talk about just about everything. I don't give advice, suggestions, information, or recommendations. I just share with you my perspective on different topics, as is with this one. And so I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five of my channels. Links are pinned at the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me, I will likely connect with you as well. So I wanted to tell you the story about my first apartment, the big red car, and the angel in the trench coat under the lamppost. Well, I've told this story before. I'll add a few more details in this one. So, you know, I'm kind of repeating some stories, and some stories I'm telling brand new. So if you go back about a year ago onto my videos, you will probably find this story at some point. And so I've told a lot of stories, but I just felt the need here lately to go back to storytelling, and you know, there's wisdom in stories. There's always wisdom in stories, but just not straight wisdom for right now. And so my first apartment, well, I was about 17 years old and I was ready to take off into the real world. I wanted to go to the big city. Well, the big city was actually about 2 hours away, and we had some family friends that lived in a little town close by that big city. It was a tiny little country town. And this big city was really like a very small city, if at that. It was more like a big town. And anyhow, I had, you know, and I talked about my first red car. My first car was a 65 Chevy Impala, bought for $75 in a farm field that my mother had bought out of the newspaper, taken it home, and took like 4 months for my stepfather to redo it, because it just roared and smoked and shimmied, and oh my gosh, it was huge. This huge, big red Chevy Impala was my first car. And so I decided I was going off, and I was gonna stay with our friends until I could find me a place and a job. So there I was in my polyester floral blouse, I think I had jeans on, some sandals, and my pocketbook, my purse, that big stiff bra that my mom's friend, my older lady friend, had given me. I was a big stiff bra, you know, because back then, you know, we didn't have the kind of bras that one of my first bras from when I was younger, but I don't know, for one reason or another, I wore it. I don't know. I wanted to look very adult-like. And after all, I was 17 years old, had graduated high school, around 17 years old. And so I got in my big red Chevy Impala with my mom crying because she didn't want to see me leave. But nonetheless, I got in my big red Chevy Impala and roared off into the sunset. And it was actually, I had to take a bunch of country roads to get to our friend's house for about 2.5 hours, got there. And I started to look for jobs. And I actually found a job as a prep girl in the back of a brand new restaurant, you know, peeling potatoes and making salads and stuff like that. And so that was my first job there. But later I was to get shortly there later, I was to get a job as the head hostess at a pizzeria. And I would wear short skirts and platform shoes and great big hair. So when I roared off into the sunset in my polyester blouse and sandals and, you know, purse and all of that, I stayed with our friends for about a week. And then my friends found me an apartment for $9 a week. I got the deluxe apartment because it was the only one available. There were other less expensive ones on the second and third level. This was like what I call a haunted mansion. And it was an old mansion converted into efficiency apartments for old ladies and women of questionable values. I was neither. And so I made friends with the old ladies and I made friends with the women of questionable values. And I had a little hot plate, a gas hot plate, back one of the old fashioned ones, and a little gas heater, which didn't work very well, one of the old fashioned ones. A bed that sank down in the middle with a spring in the middle was terrible. I slept on the floor most of the time. I had a dress, or kind of a shrunk dresser type of thing where I could put my clothes. And I had a table and chairs. I had a little refrigerator and a pickle barrel that I got from work, a plastic pickle barrel that I would carry down to the bathroom that I shared with the old ladies. I would wash my dishes in that and my laundry too. And so that was where I lived for about the next 6 months. Now, I began to work really a lot at the pizza place. And so I was working very late hours. And I sent my big red Chevy back home because it kept stalling out. And so I was basically taking the bus to work. And then on the way home, one of the, you know, guys from work would give me a ride home and drop me off. And so I continued to work there. And so one of the friends had said, hey, let's go down to the mall. Well, I had never been to a mall because we'd never had malls where I was from. And they just built this mall. Well, we went there and there was a wig shop in there. And they had this Dolly Parton-like wig. And so I said, I want that. And it was $19.95, which was like a whole paycheck almost for me at the pizzeria. And so, but I bought it. And I went home and I stuck, you know, pinned my own hair up and I put this wig on. And oh my gosh, I was in heaven. I had this huge Dolly Parton like looking wig, and away I went. And I mean, I have to tell you, well, the guys were, you know, kind of falling all over me before that, but I didn't want to date anybody because I was still really only 17, but I was telling everybody I was 18. And now I had this big wig, which even made guys want to go out with me even more. And so I'm running around with platform shoes, short mini skirt, because, you know, mini skirts were in that period of time. Platform shoes were in, you know, bell bottom pants. I think we just came out of that phase. I remember having the mini midi max coat where you zipped it on and zipped it off each layer. If you wanted a midi coat, if you wanted a mini coat, if you wanted a maxi coat. And so I remember all that. And I mean, but platform shoes, I mean, just running around in platform shoes at work, I mean, that was not easy to do. Big hair. Now I had big hair at work instead of, you know, my own hair. I had this great big Dolly Parton wig on. I mean, the guys were coming like, oh, hey, baby, let's go out. You know, it was hilarious, hilarious. But what had happened during this time period was a man began to stand outside of the, well, let me backtrack first. I had one guy pursuing me who owned a business about 10 years old, a very handsome guy. He was pursuing me, but he would show up at my door. And because it was an old lady house and questionable values, guys weren't supposed to come in, although guys would sneak in to the efficiency apartments of the women with questionable values, but they weren't supposed to come in. And, you know, I didn't date anybody. I really didn't want to date anybody. I did date a couple times, but I really didn't want to date anybody. I was too scared to date. And so anyhow, this one guy, I remember he was very handsome and he kept coming over and he was kept asking the old ladies, you know, can she see me outside? And I'd say, no. And because I'd walk to church on Sunday and I would pass by his place and he would see me and he really liked me. So anyhow, so that is what kind of happened. So anyhow, I was, this man started showing up under the street lamp. And then he would come over, ring the doorbell. But this has only happened when I was gone at work. And they would all tell this man, they'd say, is Diane there? Because he called me Diane. Is Diane there? And they'd say, no, she's at work. But he never came to work that I know of. And he was in a trench coat. So, I mean, he would stand under, just like in the movies, the man in the trench coat under the lamp, under the street lamp, street light, and it could have been fog. It was foggy or raining or whatever. He was over there every night under the street lamp. And he would come ring the doorbell and be told the same thing. She's at work. I never saw this man, but the old, every one of the old ladies did. The landlady, I believe, did. All the ladies of questionable values did, or at least most of them did. But I didn't see this man, and he never came on the nights that I was home. Never came. But it scared me, and it scared my mother when she found out. And she came down, packed my stuff, and took me away, and sent me off to a university. And I ended up at a university. But this is the interesting thing. It took me a little bit of time to put this together, why this happened and who this man was. I believe that there were some hidden dangers in there, because remember, I was young, naive, fresh out of the, you know, out of high school, and I was on my own for the first time. And some of the women in that big old mansion were questionable and had questionable boyfriends that were coming and going in the middle of the night, you know, when the old ladies were asleep. And perhaps I was in some kind of danger. And I believe that that man in the trench coat that came every night was an angel. He was an angel warning me and putting a little bit of, I don't know, fear is the right word, in me that I needed to get going. So I've had other experiences with angels and later in my life, and I have shared those. And so you have to kind of dig back into my videos archive if you want some of those videos. I think one was called The Angel in the Black Mercedes, and another one was called Angel Down the Dark Alley. And but this angel, I believe, came to warn me that maybe I was in danger and that I needed to get out of there. And indeed I did, and moved on with my life. It was time for me to move on. So I never personally saw that angel. I never saw that man in the trench coat. I never saw him, whereas everyone else did. And it wasn't one person that saw him. It was a lot of people that saw this man. And he came consistently, and would ring the doorbell, because, you know, men could not come into the mansion because it was really for all women. And it was an old, old haunted kind. I called it the haunted mansion, but I don't think it was really haunted. And many years later, I think it was torn down. But yeah. So that was my first apartment, my first car for $75. The big wig that I had, the Dolly Parton wig. You know, it wasn't a Dolly Parton wig. It was a Dolly Parton look-alike type of wig. And the angel in the trench coat. What I believe to be an angel in a trench coat. You know. Angels can come in earthly form, and they can also come in spiritual form, and I kind of find it, kind of think that maybe that angel was in a spiritual form looking like a person. I don't know. You may not believe in angels, but I do. So anyhow, I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below, and I hope to talk to y'all soon again. From my house to yours, may God bless you. Talk to you then. Bye-bye. To relax.